about classical and operant conditioning, things like Skinner and Pavlov. We have a really unique partnership here with the zoo, where the students get to come out here as part of their lab. It really is a lab for them. These aren't students with a previous history of animal training, so they're just kind of given a quicker and some brain at the beginning of the semester and a quick crash course in operant conditioning, and they get to pick an animal and pick a behavior that they want to train. They write up a plan about how they want to train it, and that gets approved by us and by the zoo, and they start out training. So with their own behaviors, they have a couple weeks where they get used to working with the goats. They get maybe 10 sessions throughout the semester, and they're only about 15 minutes each. So it's a really short amount of time that they get with the animals. So I think you'll be impressed by what they're able to accomplish here by the end of the semester. The animal
that we worked with is Fur. We worked with him on a novel behavior of bowing. To shape this behavior, we used his previously trained behavior of targeting to a target. Forced him targeting his nose to the target stick first, and then slowly moved that to the ground, and then towards this platform you see back here. We utilized this platform because when we put the target stick underneath the platform, in order for him to target completely and receive a positive reinforcement of clicking grain, under the platform, it required him to get on both knees, which was our operational definition of bowing for him. We made sure that we always fed directly to him underneath the platform, and as a result of this, we realized quickly that his behavior was under the stimulus control of both the target stick underneath the platform, as well as us feeding directly to him as the reward. This allowed us to quickly phase out the target stick as part of the reinforcement, as a stimulus, and we quickly added the physical stimulus.
Sorry, bow.
The physical stimulus of us bowing to him, which was our goal stimulus. So show a little bit of it.
So I want to point out that I'm doing this with my right hand. So let me show you. Here we go. Okay. And so if you notice, I did that with my right hand, as I was saying before. That actually became a little bit of a problem, and so we kind of tried and switched to doing my left hand as well. Okay, I'm right-handed.
So for those of you that don't know that song, I'm not going to sing it, but the lyrics start out, it's like you have to move to the right 3 times, to the left 3 times, you kick, but in this case, Phineas is going to circle, and then you walk it back, so just go back. So we used a form of called back training, in which we taught the last move of the dance first. So we started with the back behavior,
and
Phineas had previously been taught the back behavior by students another semester, or zookeepers here, but we wanted to extend this back behavior to where Phineas could do it for up to 3, 4, 5 steps without us reinforcing after each step. So when we started training this, we ran into a problem with Phineas curving. He had, I think it was last semester, the semester before last, he was taught to do the reverse behavior, which he's doing now, and so when he would go back, so in order to counteract this, we used a variable schedule of reinforcement in which we started out just reinforcing for very short movements before he would start to curve, and we would extend this for longer and longer and longer. So when we got that, we moved on to the next step in the behavior, which is circle, and Phineas had also previously been taught to circle, but we wanted to fade this cue, so the original cue was like this. We wanted to make it just a little finger movement so it was more subtle in the dance, and also we circle with him in the dance. So then we moved on to the last 2 steps in the dance, which was sidestepping.
One way that we tried to get him to be sidestep, Phineas
are in areas around Sussex, England. So the behavior I trained this semester was that Sheldon would leave and make a figure eight around these two weak poles. Specifically, I would be standing here, and Sheldon would be to my left, and then we would approach the poles. Sheldon would then circle the one on his right, followed by the one on his left, as the behavior. So initially, the way we did this, we also used a target stick. Remember somebody speaking about that earlier? Use a target stick and lead him to where we wanted to go. However, we realized that that's not actually reinforcing the behavior of making a figure eight. It's just reinforcing more of the behavior of following the target stick. So we ended up getting rid of that. Instead, we did make enough progress with the target stick to where Sheldon would approach the lead poles. And so instead, we just differentially reinforce it in various locations. So Sheldon would approach the lead poles, reinforce over here to where he would continue going there. Once that continued, we continually reinforce where he needed to go. And ultimately, the behavior would form. Problems I had with this behavior. So as you know, right and left are very hard for some people even. I was actually training in that area of the yard, and we were doing pretty well, and then we realized when we moved to another part of the yard, he wasn't always circling the right one. In fact, he was always circling the one closest to this side of the gate. In order to fix that, we had to start moving in various places of the yard, and we'd only reinforce if he circled to the right ultimately. What he should be able to do is approach the poles from any direction, and always circle the one on his right. Actually do it from the other side as well.
Hi, my name is Stephen Jan. This man is Hungry. And our animal is Frankie. He's a sausage clown, baby dog sheep. And he's about 1.5 years old. And the new behavior which this man heard is playing the piano. They have no experience with the piano before. And we use the piano as the display. In the training, we basically use the successive approximation and approximation for the training. And there are basically four steps. The first is when Franklin watch this panel, we click and reinforce them. And then when they watch this panel, we click and reinforce them. If the third is any part of his head, actually any part of his family. The last one is when his chin or his nose touch the keys of the piano and make a sound.
Play the piano, Franklin. Play it.
circle around her, and then I would use the cue for come to get him to my come to my left side, and I would click and treat, and he came to my left hand, and then he would circle and then go back over to the left.
Ha ha ha.